Repeat. So this is 170 degrees. Then angle AOD 130 degrees. Actually, if you see the angle, this BD is looking like a straight angle, so some of these two angles must be 180 degrees. So let us take 90 degrees and this also 90 degrees. Now if you measure, actually you will get BOC and COD both, you will get 90. So angle BOC also 90. So then angle BOD 90 plus 90, it is 180 degrees. Now let us write the type of each angle. So the angle AOB is 60 degrees, so it is acute angle. And angle BOC is 90 degrees, so it is a right angle. And angle COD also right angle. Angle DOA, it is more than 90 and less than 180. So it is obtuse angle. Next 180 degrees, it is a straight angle. Next angle AOC 130 degrees. So it is more than 90 and less than 180. So it is also obtuse angle. Now let us see the next topic, perpendicular lines. Now when the two lines intersect, an angle between two intersecting lines is a right angle. A line L and line M both are intersecting at a right angle. So then the two lines are said to be perpendicular lines. So if the angle between two intersecting lines is a right angle, means 90 degrees, then the two angles and the two lines are said to be perpendicular lines. So if line L is perpendicular to M, if L is perpendicular to M, we write L is perpendicular to M. So this is the symbol for perpendicularity. So we write L is perpendicular to M. If the two lines AB and CD are perpendicular to each other, so then we write AB is perpendicular to CD. Now let us see the next question. Based on the perpendicular lines, let PQ be the perpendicular to the line segment XY. So actually here XY, let PQ and XY intersect in the point A. What is the measure of angle PAY? So first let us draw the figure showing the given question. So PQ be the perpendicular to the line segment XY. So first let us draw line segment XY. And PQ be the perpendicular to the line segment XY. PQ and XY intersect in the point A. So the line segments PQ and XY intersect in the point A. So then what is the measure of angle PAY? So the measure of angle PAY equals to 90 degrees, because the angle between two perpendicular lines is a right angle. So the measure of angle PAY is 90. So automatically all the four angles will be right angles. So angle PAX equals to 90 degrees. Angle XAQ, angle XAQ equals to 90 degrees. Angle YAQ also 90 degrees. Now let us see the next question. Study the diagram. The line L is perpendicular to the line M. So on the line L, 0 to 8 marking is given, and A2, now 1 to 8 are represented by A, B, C, D up to H. Now let us see the first question. Is CE equal to EG? So from C to E, so this is 2 units, 2 centimeters, and E to G also 2 centimeters. So we can write that, yes, CE equal to EG, each 2 centimeters. The second question, does PE bisect CG? So PE means there is a point P marked on the line M. So we have to check whether PE bisects CG. So then we have to find the distance from C to E and E to G. So CE and EG both are equal. So we can say that CE equal to EG. CE equals to EG equals to 2 centimeters. So yes, PE bisects CG. Next question. Identify any two line segments for which PE is the perpendicular bisector. So PE is the perpendicular bisector means it should divide any line segment equally and perpendicularly. So then we can say that DF is the perpendicular bisector of, means PE is the perpendicular bisector of DF, because DE equal to EF. So we can say that DF is the perpendicular bisector. Next, CG is the perpendicular bisector. So already it is written there, CG is the perpendicular bisector, and also BH. So because B to E and E to H, so B to E 1, 2, 3 centimeters, and E to H 1, 2, 3 centimeters. So we can say that BH is a perpendicular, P is a perpendicular bisector of BH. Next, are these true? So first one, AC greater than FG. AC greater than FG. FG is 1 centimeter, but AC is 2 centimeters. So then we can say that AC is greater than FG. So it is true. Next, CD equal to GH. CD is 1 centimeter. GH also 1 centimeter. So both are equal. So it is also true. Next, BC less than EH. BC is 1 centimeter, B to C, less than EH. EH is 3 centimeters, 1, 2, 3 centimeters. So then 1 less than 3, so it is also true. Now let us see the next topic, classification of triangles. A triangle means it is a simple closed figure bounded by the three line segments. So how to classify the triangles based on the sides and also the base on the angles? So we can classify the triangles in three types. So based on the sides, and again three types on base on the angles. So first let us classify the triangles based on the sides. First one is equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle means a triangle in which all the three sides are equal. So then it is called an equilateral triangle. So a triangle in which all the three sides are equal. Next, see the equilateral triangle. So in this, three sides are equal in triangle ABC. AB equal to BC equal to AC. So then it is called equilateral triangle. Now the second type of triangle is isosceles triangle. So in this, a triangle in which two sides are equal. So if you take the triangle with two equal sides, then it is called isosceles triangle. Here AB equal to AC, two sides are equal. Now the third type of triangle is scalene triangle. Now a triangle in which all the three sides are unequal. So if you take a triangle ABC with all the different sides, so then it is called a scalene triangle. So equilateral triangle means a triangle in which all the three sides are equal, then automatically all the three angles will be equal. And isosceles triangle means a triangle in which two sides are equal. So if two sides are equal, then their opposite angles also will be equal. Next, scalene triangle means a triangle in which all the three sides are different, means all three sides are unequal. So then it is called scalene triangle. Now this is the classification of the triangles based on the sides of the triangle.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.